Hey buddy, in this lesson, we're going to talk about screw back shots. Now some of you have already experimented a little bit with backspin, but in this video, we're going to show you how to do screw back shots and how useful they actually can be. Now backspin is one thing, but screw back has a larger goal than just spinning the ball back. It's actually about positioning. That's what we're going to cover in this video. Now, the 12 ball in front of me here, going to putt it. I will also add backspin to the cue ball so it avoids the cue ball from going in. At the other side of the table, there's the one ball. Notice how much I travel from one side to the other side of the table. Now, if the one ball would be my last ball of this frame, I only have to play a really easy shot to win the frame, and it will make such a big difference if I didn't put all that backspin on the table and didn't got that position. So, screw back shot is something you really want to add to your shot collection, so it will improve your positional play, eventually lead to better positions, more ball spotting, and winning frames. Now, in order to make a screw shot, we have to apply some spin. I suggest you use directional keys to apply spin, as they do not add any unwanted side spin to the ball. Now, if you want to know more about adding no side spin to the ball, there's a specific lesson to that. In lesson 3 of the masterclass, we discuss it, how you can exactly do that. Now for this shot, I'm gonna put my tip under the center, which you've probably seen already and done before, called the stun shot. And you put the tip under the center, shoot the ball, and you got a stun shot. Now for a screw back shot, you have to go at least to 75% or 3/4 of the ball to get it screw shot going on. Gonna add 2 bars of power. Gonna hit roughly 1 cushion here. Gonna do the same again. This time I'm gonna put the cue a little bit lower. But I'm gonna again go for 2 bars of power and see where it lands. There we go, that's 2 cushions. Gonna do the same again. Only this time I'm gonna add 3 bars of power. And you will see the ball will travel even more further. So again, it's a combination of power and spin. Okay, I just split at the back and done my break. Got all the balls here on the table and got there a situation where a screw back is gonna help so much. I'm gonna pocket the brown ball here in the corner pocket, which I would normally do. I could also do a stop shot or a stun shot and here and pocket this ball and then maybe later pocket this ball. These two are quite stuck and these two are. But if you could do, and I got it under control, and can do a screw back shot, I put this ball, I go back, hit the cushions, and it would land in this area. And suddenly, because I can do a screw back shot, these two balls are in play. And I'm going to show you now how you can do a different screw back and how you can land into different positions on the field. One more thing to remember. In this video, I only demonstrate straight screw back shots, not under an angle, because if you shoot under an angle, the ball is gonna end different. The cue ball is gonna end on a different position when you shoot under an angle. So we only do straight screw back shots, and angle shot is something we cover in another video. So same position as we just saw on the picture. Going to add 2 bars of power and a screw back effect. Ball goes back, and suddenly those two balls came into play. Got the exact same shot here in front of me, only gonna put 1 more bar of power, and suddenly that lands into a different position on the table. Just as you can see, the power is really important as well to control, and it will result sometimes on the position where you will land and have a great impact on the next ball you will play. After that being all explained, we come to the end of this video. So hopefully you guys learned and picked up something about screw back shots. One more final time, so screw back shot, 3/4 ball, 75%, around that area is where you start to shoot for screw backs. As you can see in the video, 2 or 3 bars will give you quite a margin to play on a full table almost, so keep a little bit with that, and it's a real great way to start with your screw back shots and get going, and from that point start to improve and get better at it. Thank you for watching, and we're gonna see you next time.